Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. In this video, we will learn how to measure capacitance with DMM. Identify capacitor symbol on the dial and turn the dial to that position. Meter enters into resistance mode first. To activate this yellow colored marking, we must press this shift button. Now the meter enters into capacitance mode and we can see nanofarads marking on the display. Before measuring capacitance on the circuit, ensure that power is disconnected to the circuit and discharge the capacitors by connecting a 20 kilo ohm 5 watt resistor across the capacitor two terminals. We need to connect the resistor at least 5 seconds across the capacitor's two terminals in order to completely discharge the capacitor. Do not short the capacitor's terminals using a screwdriver or with any other metal to discharge the capacitor, as it may damage the capacitor. Visually inspect the capacitor if any bulges or other signs of damages in the capacitor. Replace them with new one. Do not try to measure capacitance when it is in the circuit, as it gives inaccurate reading due to other parallel components in the circuit. Hence, disconnect the capacitor from the circuit board. The best way is to desolder the capacitor from circuit. Sometimes we can observe a small residual capacitance between the open-ended test probes. For accurate measurement of capacitance value, the relative mode can be used to remove the capacitance of the test lead. Press the REL button. This removes the residual capacitance value of the test lead. While holding the test probes, never let your fingers to touch the metal part of the test lead. In case of polarized capacitors, connect the black probe to the negative terminal. Usually, there will be marking on the side of the capacitor, and connect the red probe to the positive terminal of the capacitor, generally longer lead. Keep test leads connected for a few seconds to allow the multimeter to automatically select the proper range. Now check the measurement on the display. If the multimeter reading are closer to the actual value mentioned on the capacitor, then the capacitor can be considered as a good capacitor. In case of non-polarized capacitor, we can connect the probes in either way, as they do not have polarity. If the meter displays OL reading, then the capacitor is faulty. A faulty capacitor may have lower or higher capacitance value than the actual value mentioned on the capacitor. Some multimeters have dedicated ports like this for placing capacitor to measure its value. If your multimeter didn't have capacitance setting, you can use resistance mode to test the capacitor. This method might not be accurate and doesn't give the capacitance value, but we can differentiate between a good and bad capacitor. Set the multimeter in ohmic range. Connect the multimeter probes to the capacitor terminals, negative to negative and positive to positive. Current flows through the capacitor and capacitor starts charging. A series of resistance values appears on the meter's display and finally progress towards OL reading. Now reverse the test lead. The capacitor starts discharging, so the resistance value keeps on decreasing. After reaching some lower value, the capacitor starts charging again. Hence, the resistance value increases and finally progresses towards infinity. This type of action shows that capacitor is in good condition. Suppose if only constant very high value appears on the display, that indicates the capacitor is open, means faulty. Likewise, if the reading stuck at a very low value, that indicates there may be a short in the capacitor. It's faulty. Let's see how to test a capacitor by using continuity test mode. Set the DMM in continuity test mode. Connect the meter's test leads to the capacitor's terminals. Positive terminal to the red probe and negative terminal to the black probe respectively. If the meter shows a proper continuity with beep sound and gradually increases and shows an OL reading, it means the capacitor in a good condition. If the multimeter shows continuity with beep sound continuously without any increase, it means the capacitor is short, it's faulty. If the multimeter doesn't show continuity with beep sound and shows OL reading, it means capacitor is open, it's faulty. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.